app icons for visionOS have a 3D parallax effect that you see here. I'm going to demonstrate how to do this by adapting my iOS app icon for Creator View to this style. I'll show you how to use Apple's Parallax Preview tool so you can quickly iterate on your 3D design and really dial it in. And I'll discuss the issues I ran into, like transparencies and gradients, and how to deal with that, and share some best practices so you can create an awesome visionOS app icon. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. To get this 3D parallax effect, we'll need to convert our app icon to three layers. There's a base layer and two transparent layers that pop out to give that 3D effect. Now, most likely you designed your app icon, or a designer did it for you, in a design tool like a Sketch or Figma. And in that case, you probably already have the layers, right? Here's the main app icon I got delivered. And you can see I can click on the play button, you know, move that around, the graph, move that around, right? There's all different layers. So this allows me to easily create my own three layers that I need. Now, we don't have to worry about shadows or anything because Apple's going to handle that for us. Now, I'm not going to go through the tedious exact things of what I did because I did do a lot of tedious stuff with my gradients and transparencies and shadows, because that's just unique to my app icon. You know, I went for that Big Sur 3D effect, and it may not affect yours, but I will show you what I did and talk through it. So, you know, if you have something similar, you know, you may understand the changes you have to make to your existing app icon. So why do I have two, a black and a white? Well, this black one was my first iteration, and I want to walk you through what I did. So like I said, I need three layers. The first background layer, the black square, pretty simple. And then for my first level of 3D pop out, I wanted just the background of my chart, right? Because if I go to my app icon, you see it's just like simulating a line chart when the lines are going up and to the right. So I have my chart there. And then the third level of my transparency are the elements, right? The play button and the lines on the line chart. And this was my first iteration, right? I didn't make any changes to the app. I just did it as is, broke it out into three layers. But as you can see here, didn't look that great for a number of reasons. First up, let's talk about like transparencies, gradients, and shadows, right? As you see, my lines here on the line chart have this nice, you know, transparent gradient underneath it. That doesn't play nicely with the transparent version of the visionOS apps. So that was one big thing I had to touch on. And again, I had to delete a lot of shadows on each of these elements. And you may notice I had to make it smaller. Well, by the way, down here, this white one is the second iteration of what I did, because I also made it white because on a black background, you can't really see the shadows pop out like you see here. So I made it white, mostly for this video, so you could see the shadows. I made the background of my chart a little lighter because it was overpowering. And then I made this smaller. You may not be able to notice that. And here's why. So you actually may run into this too with your app icon, because it's meant to be like in a square. So I put a little oval on here to show you if it were cropped to be in a circle, right? So if you take my existing app icon, crop it into a circle, well, now you can see it's crammed on the edges. Some of the stuff's being cut off. As you see here, it just looks horrible. So I made all those tweaks, again, got rid of the transparencies, dialed down the shadows, and made this middle smaller so it would fit inside a circle. So once you have your three layers, like I do, and again, this first one, solid color, no transparencies, and then the middle layer and the top layer need to be transparent background. So when you export your files, make sure the top two layers are transparent. Now, once you have your files exported, you can just go right into Xcode, but I'm going to take an intermediate step and go to Apple's Parallax Preview, because I think this is what you should do if you're doing kind of what I did, how your initial design didn't quite work, so you had to make a bunch of design tweaks and you're doing a lot of trial and error. And that's because, let me open up Parallax Previewer here. And by the way, this is a download from Apple. I'll put a link in the description. But you see, I drag my three layers there. Actually, let me close this out because I want to make sure I do File, New visionOS app icon. Because if you just do file new, that's going to take you to the Apple TV icons that have a parallax effects. That's not what we want. Make sure you do new visionOS app icon. And then I'm going to make this bigger here. So you can see, drag my artwork. And if I go to Finder, this is where I export it. So you see I have layer 0, layer 1, layer 2, but I have layer 1, layer 1A. So the initial layer 1 was my first iteration, the black one that didn't work out. So I did, you know, 0A, 1A. I just wanted to explain that, why I have 6 images and not 3. It's because this is, you know, first iteration, second iteration. So I'm going to take layer 0A, which again is the white background. Layer 1A, which as you can see is just my chart. And then layer 2A, which is the top layer. I believe I might have these in the wrong order in the Parallax Previewer. I do. So layer 0 needs to be on the bottom, layer 1 in the middle, layer 2 on the top. There you go. So now you can see my app icon. And when I hover over it, you see it pop out with the shadows. That's what we get. And then as I move around, it moves around. So I can see the parallax effect. I can see it popping out with the shadows. So again, the reason I recommend doing it first in Parallax Previewer, if you're making design tweaks, is because you can view this a lot bigger and you can really, you know, see it and dial it in. But once you have it dialed in and you have these files, you know, layer 0, layer 1, layer 2, or whatever you named them, now we can go into Xcode. So I'm going to go to Xcode. And this is just a file new visionOS app. Haven't written a line of code. It's not a starter project or anything like that. So file new visionOS app, this is what you get. So all I'm doing is going to my assets, and you can see the app icon, you might have to hit this little down arrow, has front, middle, and back. So we just want to do what we just did in Parallax Previewer pretty much. So the front is layer 2A, the middle is layer 1A, and then the back is my solid white square. So there you go. And like I said, you get this mini Parallax Previewer here, but it is kind of small, even, you know, blown up on a big screen. So that's why the Parallax Previewer, you get a much bigger version if you're really trying to dial in the details. If you want to just go right to Xcode, that's probably fine too, because you do get a preview of that here. So let's go and run the app and actually see this running in real time. All right, here I am in the simulator. As I said, it's just the Hello World app, but if I hit the home button in the upper right, that's going to pull up my app icons, but it pulled it up right on top of my app. So let's move the app out of the way so you're not distracting. Hit the home button again. There we go. There's my app icons. Let me zoom in a little and maybe get an angle so we can see the shadows. Admittedly, getting these shadows to show up in the simulator is a little finicky, but we'll see if they do. Highlight, okay, no shadows. All right, I'm gonna play with the angle a little bit. I may have to cut and then just show up at a time when I have the shadow showing up. In a real device, obviously, this is not an issue. Okay, found the angle where shadows will show up. But as I put the mouse cursor over it, which simulates your eyes moving around in the Vision Pro, you saw it pop out with the shadows in the 3D parallax effect. And if you're here learning about this, I bet you're building an awesome app for Apple Vision Pro. And it's a very good idea as an iOS developer to have a portfolio website to showcase your work so people can easily see it. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio, blog, or personal website up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're all developers with the skills and the desire to build the web page ourselves. But I would argue there's an opportunity cost to your time. If you're an iOS developer trying to build a great product, a great app, maybe spending a lot of time learning the ins and outs of web development, responsive design, isn't the best way to spend your time. That's why I recommend Squarespace to build that personal website, the blog, your portfolio, or maybe a landing page for your app. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started. They handle all the analytics and the SEO for you. Again, it just saves you so much time so you can get back to doing what you want to do, and that is building iOS apps. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.